What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, legendary promoter, top-ranked CEO, Bob Arum, who promotes undefeated three-division world champion, former junior welterweight undisputed world champion, currently the WBO welterweight world champion, who is widely considered the number one pound-for-pound fighter in the world, Terrence Bud Crawford. And he's looking and talking about the possible massive mega showdown, which is considered the biggest fight in the sport of boxing. That's Terrence Crawford, his fighter, against undefeated, unified WBC, IBF, welterweight, world champion, superstar boxer, Earl "The Truth" Spence Jr. With that said, as he was describing and breaking down the possibility of this fight, and what's next for Terrence Crawford if he's not able to secure that massive fight with Errol Spence? And is it Terrence Crawford pay-per-view worthy with any other fight? And shockingly, or should I say not shockingly, Bob Arum says Terrence Crawford is not pay-per-view worthy unless the fight includes Errol Spence Jr. He says if it doesn't include Errol Spence Jr., there's no fight that we could put Terrence Crawford in that would be pay-per-view worthy. And he states that we shouldn't have put the pay-per-view events on that we did put on with Terrence Crawford because they weren't huge success. And that is Terrence Crawford. His first pay-per-view was against Victor Postol in a unification bout when he was at junior welterweight. And it reportedly did 60,000 pay-per-view buys. And in his second pay-per-view was against former multi-division world champion, British superstar, Amir King Kong. The problem is, Amir Kong was far past his prime when his fight was placed and staged. And it did, according to reports and according to Bob Arum, 150,000 pay-per-view buys. With that said, this is a clear confirmation when Errol Spence says he wants 60-40 split in his favor, which is generous because he's the bigger star. He's the bigger pay-per-view star. He's doing bigger numbers. The proof is in the pudding. The numbers don't lie. And Bob Arum states that Terrence Crawford is just not successful on pay-per-view. He just don't promote himself, and he's just not a big enough star. And then, of course, Bob Arum says, you know, well, the pay-per-view market in this current time with the pandemic and social distancing and fans not fully being able to engage in live sporting events, he said that market is pretty much in the dumpster. So this is a confirmation that Terrence Crawford is indeed the B-side and should accept 60-40. Bob Arum also stated prior to this interview took place today. In a prior interview, Bob Arum stated that he lost so much money on Terrence Crawford in his last three fights leading into the last fight he had with Kell Brook that he could build a mansion from scratch in Beverly Hills. And then Bob Arum stated that Terrence Crawford simply just doesn't promote himself. He's difficult to work with, and he's not interested in making other fights other than Errol Spence or Manny Pacquiao. So with that said, when it was talked about a possibility of Terrence Crawford facing Errol Spence said, give me take a 60-40 split and we can make the fight happen in my favor because the numbers don't lie. So when Bob Arum says that there's no fight for Terrence Crawford that's worthy of putting on pay-per-view, this just simply lets you know it's a clear indication that Errol Spence is indeed the biggest star. Because guess what? Errol Spence in his last three fights were on pay-per-view and it was a success. Don't let people tell you that it wasn't a success, because certain numbers are inflated. You're not going to see the numbers of Floyd Mayweather anymore, Manny Pacquiao in his heyday. Those numbers, those days are all done. Why? Because people find a way to illegally stream the fights. Deontay Wilder Tyson Fury first fight, it reportedly was illegally streamed 20 million streams. 20 million people found a way to not pay for the fight, but still watch the fight. So those days that Floyd Mayweather did 4.3 million pay-per-views and 3.5 and all those numbers inflated, it's never going to happen again. Because at that point in time, people were just stumbling upon social media and all these different platforms and all these different streaming apps and all these different ways to be able to watch these fights. You couldn't do it then. You had to go either go to somebody's house and watch it collectively, go to the fight, or order it. That doesn't exist anymore. Now people find a way to maneuver around. So with that said, Errol Spence has done pay-per-views his last three fights, and they were success. Why? Because they were over 300,000 pay-per-view buys. He did 350,000 pay-per-view buys with Mikey Garcia, four-division world champion, Mexican superstar boxer. And he did 325,000 pay-per-view buys with two-time welterweight world champion, superstar boxer, Showtime Sean Porter. And in his last fight, he did a reported 310,000 pay-per-view buys with two-division world champion, Danny Swift Garcia. So with that said, it's abundantly clear. First off, the numbers don't lie when you in comparison. Two fights combined with Terrence Crawford did 210 combined pay-per-views, and Errol Spence, one pay-per-view, his lowest was 310. That's still 100,000 more pay-per-views sold on the part of Errol Spence in one fight combined to Terrence Crawford, two pay-per-view events. So this just is a clear indication that Errol Spence deserves 60-40 split in his favor to stage what is considered the biggest fight in the sport of boxing. With that said, Bob Arum states that Terrence Crawford needs Errol Spence to do pay-per-views. And if he's saying that Terrence Crawford needs Errol Spence to be staged and featured on a pay-per-view headline card, then that means Errol Spence doesn't need Terrence Crawford because Errol Spence is doing and headlining his own pay-per-view cards. Now, this is to take nothing away from the fight because this is the biggest fight in the sport of boxing, and this needs to happen for the sport of boxing. But it's a clear indication of who's holding up the fight from taking place when Errol Spence is saying take a 60-40 split in my favor, and Terrence Crawford is saying take a 50-50 split or there's no fight. Well, Terrence Crawford is holding up the fight at that point in time. But not to mention Bob Arum, in stating all this, Bob Arum also states that he's waiting for founder and advisor of PBC, Premier Boxing Champions, Al Haymon, to bend and give a 50-50 split, or there won't be any fight either. So that is also the mindset of and mind makeup of Bob Arum when it comes to this fight, because Bob Arum wants to profit off of the biggest fight in the sport of boxing. He don't want to lose out. He don't want Terrence Crawford to take a 60-40 split because then he loses out. He wants to maximize as much dollars as he possibly can for himself as well as Terrence Crawford. So he's saying that he'll continue to let Al Haymon put on these pay-per-view events and essentially start to lose money because he's not having this fight with Terrence Crawford. So he's holding on to the ace card, which is Terrence Crawford ultimately, to make the biggest fight. And he don't want to relinquish that because he understands that this would be his last gasp with Terrence Crawford, as Terrence Crawford is a free agent after October. So Bob Arum doesn't want to lose out on this big, massive fight before Terrence Crawford exited his company and his platform. With that said, Terrence Crawford needs to understand that Bob Arum doesn't value him. He doesn't see value in him. Not to mention, Terrence Crawford has been looking to secure a massive legacy, big payday fight against eight division world champion, iconic Filipino superstar boxer who's currently the WBA welterweight world champion, Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao. And Bob Arum put a halt to it. And he cited that he did so because he didn't want to see Manny Pacquiao get hurt. And nor did he feel like Manny Pacquiao was worth the $20 million he was looking for. And he didn't think that Manny Pacquiao versus Terrence Crawford would be a big draw, so he won't see a return on his investment. So Terrence Crawford needs to identify that his value with Bob Arum, in the eyes of Bob Arum, is not very high. And so therefore, Terrence Crawford should definitely be looking to exit Top Rank as fast as possible. Get a fight in. Bring up your value. In my opinion, he should fight Sean Porter, who's his WBO mandatory challenger, in which Bob Arum stated that Sean Porter and Keith Thurman, former unified WBC, WBA, welterweight world champion, superstar boxer, are only worth a flat fee of $1 million. So it's abundantly clear that Bob Arum is not willing to invest in opponents for Terrence Crawford's legacy in the future. So I believe that he should look to secure a fight with Sean Porter, who's his mandatory challenge, bring up his stock. Then once you become a free agent, I would fight Sean Porter in June. Then October, you're a free agent. Then you look to make the Errol Spence fight and negotiate and sign with PBC or do a one-fight deal for Errol Spence or a two-fight deal. You're going to have a rematch clause. I think that's the best interest for Terrence Crawford. But clearly, Bob Arum don't see any value in him. And if Bob Arum is stating that he is not a pay-per-view star without Errol Spence, then he's clearly letting you know that Errol Spence is the A-side and Terrence Crawford should take a 60-40 split. He's not doing Terrence Crawford any favors in these interviews. But that's all I got for y'all. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. You haven't subscribed? Hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.